Hello students, this is Uma Vidushi, your English teacher, and today I am going to teach you a very beautiful poem whose name is Hurtful. So without wasting much time, let's begin today's class. Dear students of Standard 7, this poem Hurtful is written by Robert McFerrin. This is the last poem of your Gulmohar English Literature book. Before reciting the stanzas of this poem, first of all, let's know about the poet. As I said, that this poem is written by Robert McFerrin, who was born on 15th August 1976. He is a British writer and fellow of Emmanuel College, Cambridge. He is a contemporary British poet and non-fiction writer. His writing is concerned with the beauty, wildness, and importance of nature. Now let's have a look on a brief synopsis of the lesson. In the poem Hurtful, the speaker is a tree who is talking to a woodcutter who has come to cut the tree. The tree tells him that it gives happiness and life to human beings, creatures and insects. It tells the cutter that a tree takes years to grow and just a few seconds to be felled by an axe. The tree pleads for its life and hopes to receive a little compassion from the cutter and his employers. Now, what are the important aspects of this poem? The poem has a very sad tone, as the reader can feel the pain and suffering of trees inflicted by the human beings for their greed and selflessness. The poem urges us to stop and think before cutting down or harming the trees. It urges us to be kinder and more respectful and more sensitive to these big, strong and wonderful pillars of nature that help so many creatures, including human beings, in so many ways. Now students, I will explain stanza by stanza of this poem. I request you to please sit with your book and pencil in your hand, so that you can note down few important points which you will come across during this video. In the first stanza, the poet wrote, "Would you hew me to the heart, woodcutter? Would you leave me open-hearted?" Here, the speaker is the tree who is speaking to a woodcutter. The tree is asking the woodcutter that if he would cut the tree to the core. Heartwood means the core of the trunk. Okay, means the deep center of the trunk. And leave it open and vulnerable, means in a miserable condition, in a poor condition. So here in this stanza, the tree is asking to a woodcutter that if he would cut the tree to the core, or and leave it open and vulnerable. "Put an ear to my bark, cutter. Hears my sap smutter. Mark my heartwood's beat, my leaves flutter. Would you turn me to timber, cutter? Leave me nothing but a pile of logs, a heap of brush." Here in this stanza, the tree tells the cutter to put his ear to the bark and hear the soft sound of the sap flowing through it. It also asks him to watch its leaves fluttering as if in pain or in fear. The tree also wants to know if the cutter intends to turn it into log of timber and a pile of brush. Now, further in third stanza, the poet says, I am a world cutter. I am a maker of life. Here the tree is telling about himself that he is the world. The whole world lies in it. I am a maker of life. It is also a source of life. Drinker of rain, breaker of crops, casters of shade, eater of sun. So here the tree is informing the woodcutters that it is a source of life. It absorbs rainwater. It is so strong to break the rock. It also provides cool shade, blocking out the hot rays of the sun. As you know, students, that there are many uses of a strong big tree. It provides shelters to animal and insects. It also gives many useful herbs, medicines. It also provides us fruits, shelter, vegetables, and many much more things. I am timekeeper, breath giver, deep thinker, cutter. Here cutter, every time in all the stanzas, as you observe that the word cutter is repeated. So cutter here is referred to the wood cutter. I am a city of butterflies, a country of creatures. So the tree also tells the cutter that it records and maintains time and give fresh air to breathe. It is also a wise and deep thinker who happily provides shelter to numerous butterflies and other creatures. So this way he is trying to make the woodcutter understand that it is a very important source of life. It provides many things to human beings, and it also helps to give fresh air so that we can breathe. In stanza 5, the poet has written, "But my world takes years to grow, cutter and seconds to crash. Your saw can fell me, your axe can bring me low." Here the tree reminds the woodcutter that, "Hey woodcutter, listen to me. It takes me year to grow, but it only takes few seconds to be cut down by your axe, by your saw." So he is reminding him that a tree takes years to grow. It's not a one day process. It takes many years to grow, to become strong, to become big, and it just takes few seconds to be cut down and fall down. "Do you hear these words I utter?" Utter means repeat something. Utter means to say something repeatedly. "I ask this of you. Have you heart woodcutter? Have those who sent you?" Now in the end, in the last stanza of this poem, the tree asks the woodcutter that if he has understood the importance of its survival. Here actually woodcutter refers to the all human beings who are cutting down, who are chopping down trees for their benefits, who are just cutting down the trees for making buildings, for making furnitures, for taking out piles of log and many more things. So the tree asks the woodcutter that if he has understood the importance of its survival. It also wants to know from the woodcutter if he or his employers means one who is working with the woodcutter, have a caring heart to realize the tree's critical plight. As he is going through a very miserable condition, he wants to survive. He is giving selflessly many things to the human beings, but these woodcutters, without even thinking about its pain, about its fear, it simply chopped down. They simply cut down the trees for their benefits, for earning more money. So that's all in this poem, students. I hope you have understood every stanza of this poem very clearly. I request you to please watch these videos twice or thrice so that it will help you to understand this poem line by line, stanza by stanza, more sincerely. Now let's have a look on keywords of this poem. The first word here is heartwood. So what is the meaning of heartwood? As you can see here in the picture also, it's a hard and dense inner part of a tree trunk. Then the next word is hew. Hew means cut down with an axe. Third word which you came across was sap. Sap means the juice that flows inside a living plant. Then mutter. Mutter means words spoken in a low voice, especially to express a worry or complaint, which may not be heard. That's all in this video, students. Thank you so much for staying with me till the end of the video. I recommend you to watch the next part of this video, in which I will provide you the question answer of this poem. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Take care.